Piano playing is all about fine muscle movements. We are often prescribed a movement to go in, out, up, down, rotate, and so on. But what's seldom calculated is how much. Welcome back to Joy of Practicing. I'm your host, Ferdi Talan. In order to introduce a movement to your hand and arm, one usually starts with an exaggerated gesture. That is helpful for visual understanding. But as time goes by and we start to understand the movement better, the objective is to refine it and make it smaller and smaller. If you watch cartoons growing up, there's always a version of a car going super fast that the body drags its wheels behind it. If your palm is the body of the car and your fingers the wheels, you cannot move it ahead of your wheels. And look at your palm, it's so much bigger than your fingers that a slight movement will change the trajectory of your fingers big time. This is the common cause of anxiety and in some ways could lead to hand injuries and all the sorts. Essentially, your fingers' relationship in striking the key is always straight and perpendicular. The complex movement happens in between, when your palm transports your fingers to the next location in order to strike the next note straight and so on.
So in a scale setting, there's a moment where you have to turn your hand and restart. You don't need the piano to turn you, meaning that it doesn't need to go plonk like a pole vault to do whatever funky movement you wanted to do there to bring your hand there. You don't need the piano to do this turn. You can finish the flick and turn so you take this momentum to do that. And it becomes smaller and smaller as you go. But it's not... Don't press, it's flick, finish, move, flick, finish, move. Feel, 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 flick, finish, oops. Feel, flick, finish, move.
Take a look at the difference between that and this. I'm pressing. And I'm... Yeah, it is counterintuitive because you feel like if you want to play something quick, then you need to move the bigger units first. But that's not actually true because, look, if I do and move the bigger units first, I don't have a controlled sound. I don't have a controlled sound, but if I propel myself from one to the other. It's not, the palm is a big unit and the arm is also a big unit and therefore a little movement for them can put your finger into a different trajectory. That's why you need to complete the movement first. On that note, I will leave you with this practice thought and idea, and I truly wish that it can help you practice and play beyond your own expectations. Until next time, I'm your host, Ferdi Talan.